Good morning, and welcome to this year's session of Chapel Talks. My name is Mandy Peake, and the title of my Chapel Talk is Bigotry Disguised in a Lab Coat. Science is the language of the universe. Ever since the Enlightenment, American society has valued the logic, reasoning, and truth behind scientific research, often relying on the findings of science to guide cultural beliefs and systemic change. Unfortunately, our society has deep underlying roots of sexism and homophobia, and so scientific research into gender and sexuality is often corrupted and exploited to perpetuate prejudiced ideologies that have little foundation in real science. This misuse of scientific discourse perpetuates and reinforces discrimination against those groups under the guise of scientific fact. This phenomenon is not new. Sigmund Freud, the father of modern psychology, first introduced his idea in the early 20th century that homosexuality was a curable pathological symptom and a perversion of heterosexuality. His opinion masquerading as science was then codified by the American Psychological Association, and homosexuality remained a verified mental disorder for decades. Similarly, Charles Darwin, famous for his theory of evolution, presented his baseless opinion that women were simply less evolved than men. The subjugation of women was then propagated to just be a reflection of natural law. Decades later, science is still being abused to legitimize discrimination. For example, in a legal battle deciding the fate of same-sex couples' right to adopt, opponents cited scientific studies to prove that children fare better in heterosexual households. One such study made the sweeping generalization that, quote, adolescent girls raised by lesbian parents tend to be more sexually active and adventurous than girls raised by opposite sex parents, end quote. The interviews and anecdotal evidence from the study of just 16 girls was then distorted to prove that all same-sex couples were unfit to be parents, all in the name of listening to the science. This false application of science has similarly been used in the social debate surrounding the gender wage gap. Angela Ferbaro, a researcher in feminist psychology at the Toronto Research Center, described how the wage gap has been able to persist for decades due to the historic belief in, quote, Darwinian survival of the fittest, or natural selection, that accounts for gender differences in scientific productivity, end quote. If science says that women are less evolved or capable, then it logically follows that pay should be in conjunction with the natural hierarchy, right? Therein lies the benefit of twisting science to align with societal prejudices. James Moore, a professor at Washington State University, describes how this misuse and abuse of science perpetuates the belief that, quote, such biases and assumptions are based on objective criteria as observed in nature, granting a sense of authority to preconceived views that is not necessarily deserved, end quote. Science and scientific data have the unique power to be used as irrefutable proof in social and legal debates, and so this cherry-picking of scientific findings has justified harmful generalizations and maintained social injustices. This has also led to the self-fulfilling cycle of women and sexual minorities feeling ostracized by scientific fields, and so they therefore enter scientific fields in lower rates, which allows that false science to go unchallenged and unchanged. Ultimately, science is the pursuit of truth, an idea fundamentally incompatible with bigotry and prejudice. Bigotry and prejudice always defile truth, but especially when disguised in a lab coat. Thank you.